Very good morning, students. Today we are going to start new chapter, chapter number 11, transportation in animals and plants. You know, student, that all the organisms need food, water and oxygen for their survival, and they need to transport all these to various parts of their body. Further, animals also need to transport wastes to parts from where they can be removed. So, in this chapter, we shall learn about the transportation of substances in plants and animals. So, in a multicellular organism like human being, it requires a specialized system that is known as the circulatory system. This circulatory system supports the transportation of material to different parts of the body. And the circulatory system consists of blood vessels. In the blood vessels, it contains arteries, veins and capillaries and heart. So, our first topic is blood. Blood is a liquid that we can say it is a connective tissues, and it is circulated throughout the body by the pumping action of the heart. Blood consists of plasma, RBC, WBC and platelets. So, the fluid, the liquid part of the blood, that is known as plasma, in which the cells are suspended. The second part of the blood, that is the red blood cells, and we can say RBC. So, the RBC contain a red pigment that called hemoglobin. So, due to the hemoglobin, it makes blood appears red. And hemoglobin bind with oxygen and transport it to all parts of the body. The next part is WBC, and we can say the white blood cells. The white blood cells fight against harmful germs that may enter in our body. Next is platelets. Platelets are the smallest among all the three kinds of the blood cells, that is plasma, RBC and WBC. And the platelets help in stopping blood from cut and from the injured tissue by forming a dark red clot. So, the clot is formed because of the presence of platelets in the blood. So, if we talk about what are the function of the blood. So, the function of the bloods are blood carries, digestate and absorb food nutrition from small intestine to all other parts of the body. Blood transport oxygen from the lungs to the cell of the body, and blood also transport wastes for removal from the body. Next is blood vessels. Blood vessels, we can say that there are three types of major blood vessels. These are veins, arteries and capillaries. So, what are veins? Veins are tube-like blood vessels, and it is situated just under the skin. These can be easily seen as a greenish-blue tubes on your hands and on your legs. So, the veins carries deoxygenated blood, or you can say carbon dioxide-rich blood, from body parts to the heart. Next is arteries and artery. So, the arteries are the blood vessels that carries oxygen rich blood. Veins carries deoxygenated blood, and arteries carry oxygenated blood from the heart to the all parts of the body. And arteries have thick elastic walls, and that are placed deeper under our skin. Next is capillaries. When the artery is divided into branches, again divided into smaller branches, that call capillaries. And these capillaries join together to form the large blood vessels that call veins. And the exchange of materials take place through the thin walls of the capillaries. So, I hope you have clear that the three types of blood vessels, these are veins, arteries and capillaries. Student, when you place your middle and your index finger of your right hand on the inner side of your left wrist. You feel that there is a thrombing movement. So what is this thrombing movement? This thrombing movement is known as pulse, and it is due to the blood that is flowing in the arteries. And when you count the number of beats as a per minute, that is known as your pulse rate. So what is pulse rate? The number of beats per minute, that is known as pulse rate. And a resting person, it usually has a pulse rate between 72 and 80 beats per minute. It is very important. A resting person, it usually has a pulse rate between 72 and 80 beats per minute. Our next topic is heart. Heart is an organ which beats continuously to act as a pump for the transport of blood and which carries other substances with it. Here is a picture of the section of the human heart also. So we can say the heart is the most sensitive part of our body, and it is located in the chest cavity, slightly tilted towards the left, and it is a tireless pumping station, means kabhi na thakne wala pumping station. It